It's Stephen Merchant. So listen, Stephen, we're going to test you now.
Right.
Okay, you are Hollywood.
I wish.
You don't. You can't laugh like that. You've got to believe it and be the dream.
You've got to walk like you've already got there. Yeah.
But you've walked.
You've arrived like you've walked.
Walking
you've
got to
walk
talk.
In with a...
You've got to do those things.
You've got
things.
To hold your head
you
high.
You have, yes. Okay. Even with your hay fever.
Yeah.
And we're doing Doc Hollywood now. This is where you call us up and you give us a random phrase or a made-up movie title. And we have to turn this, Stephen, into cinematic gold.
That's tricky.
Yeah. First up, we've got Michael. Good morning, Michael.
Morning.
Off you go.
Just one word. Shrubbery.
Snobbery or shrubbery?
Shrubbery.
Shrubbery?
Shrubbery.
Yeah, as in like a group of bushes.
Okay, shrubbery. Shrubbery says to me straight away, I'm getting the feeling this is a horror movie.
Stephen King.
Yeah. I mean, all of his art, there's Misery and stuff like that. I see this as a...
Which other ones?
Just Misery at the
misery
moment.
Misery is the only one you've got, yeah.
Carrie,
yes.
Fog. That's not a terrifying thing, is it? Fog.
It's some fog.
I mean, what was he going to call it? The mist. And someone went, mist isn't that frightening, but fog is.
Well, fog's pretty scary.
No, you just put your demister on the car if there's a bit of fog. You don't think, whoa,
well,
fog.
I think you think, oh, what if there's someone lurking in the fog? Not,
no,
oh,
but
the
I'd,
fog itself
I'd just
is
about
the killer.
See them. Well, they would...
it could be Psychotic Gardener.
Psychotic Gardener.
Hang on, I mean, this is the follow-up. We're dealing with the whole franchise here. Now, let's deal with Shrubbery, first of all. Shrubbery is all filmed on those handy cams. Lots of shaky stuff.
Okay, that's scary.
I imagine there's an old guy, right, and people think he's a bit of an idiot, okay, and he's the local gardener. And one day, he's tending to one of the shrubs in the community.
Right.
And he thinks he hears it talking to him.
Okay.
But it just gives numbers.
Were you thinking of Prince Charles when you came up with
this? Might have been thinking of Prince Charles is in here. Okay?
Right. Prince Charles stars as a local
gardener. Let's imagine he's a big fan of you and Ricky.
Of course he is.
You write to him, say we're in the new, we're doing the new Stephen King movie.
He thinks I'm never going to be king.
That's right.
I've got to do something with my time.
I'll be in a Hollywood movie.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay? And he hears it reading out the numbers to Shrubbery.
Reading out what numbers? The lottery numbers?
That's exactly what it is. He wins the lottery.
Because of a talking shrub?
Listen! Okay. You're looking at me.
That doesn't sound like a Stephen King.
No, but it's
idea.
A new 2010.
Sounds like the ramblings of a moron. King's one of the most successful novelists of all time.
That would be the first review, though. The ramblings,
the
of,
ramblings
a moron.
Of a moron.
Shrubbery.
Yeah.
This Christmas, Prince Charles is Shrubbery. What do you have it on then if he's not reading out the lottery numbers?
I thought you were going to say that. That the plants, that they're talking to him, and they start to inform him on stuff. You know, you've got to do this, you've got to do that, and then he starts
what,
doing
like kill
crazy
people,
psycho
he goes
stuff.
To try and kill the president.
So he's
but
like,
that's the ramblings of a moron.
No, but he's the what?
Winning the
no,
Thunderbolt. That's not the ramblings
but
of a moron.
But what's the rest of the story? He wins the lottery and then he retires.
No,
that's
then
not
gets,
a story.
No, then he gets more pertinent numbers. 75. Number 75. At number 75 is a serial killer's address. He busts open that case. The next week...
This is the worst idea I've ever heard.
You wait. I'm going to be one of those people that's driven nuts in 2 years' time. I'll see a load of posters, right, with your mug on them.
Yeah.
You're the gardener.
Shrubbery.
And I'm like, that was my idea. And people are going, oh, come on now. There's always one bitter guy like you. All right, let's go to Sarah's online too. Good morning, Sarah.
Morning, Christian. Good morning, Stephen.
Hello.
It's like going live now, isn't it, when they say hello to everyone?
This is great. She's
going
to slag me off like someone that had a go on Five Star.
Do you remember that? And Matt Bianco as well. Okay, Sarah, what's your made-up movie title for us?
Revenge of the Chocolate Cake.
Revenge of the Chocolate Cake?
Yeah.
I'm more intrigued to know how she came up with that.
Yeah, how
well,
did...
I'm making a chocolate cake right now.
Right about what you know. Isn't that what you always say?
That's it.
Yeah.
And you just said, come up with a title.
Yeah.
Chocolate cake was in my hand, so I thought I'd do
this
it.
Says to me,
okay.
Richard Curtis.
Really? You think
it's
a sort of rom-com, a charming rom-com?
Yeah, yeah. Revenge of the... What is it? Is it chocolate cake or cupcake?
Yep. No, chocolate cake.
Revenge of the Chocolate Cake.
Right, and what happens next?
I've got it. This is the pitch.
Okay.
Married couple.
Uh-huh.
You know, they are Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Everyone wants to be this married couple.
Yep.
But he's having an affair.
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you're right.
It's a Richard Curtis film. Is he played by Hugh Grant?
Hugh Grant's the cheating husband.
Okay.
Okay, Emma Thompson is the wife.
Lovely.
But there's another woman, Katie Price.
Katie Price?
It's a controversial casting.
It is.
But it works. And basically, throughout the movie, it's just like a farce. She's just about to uncover
like
the truth.
Farce.
Yes, like a farce, yes. It's just about to uncover the truth, but they keep getting away with it. However, one day she finds out. her world is shattered.
Okay.
Like the dramatic, the dropping of the pen. You know, yeah. She drops a mirror or she drops one of her favourite chocolate cakes.
Is she always making cakes? Right?
Every week, every Friday, yep. Yes. Yep. And what she decides to do is poison the chocolate cake. She kills him. But doesn't kill him, it's a very slow death. He turns into a flesh-eating zombie.
Oh, that's a shame. I thought. Do you know what? I thought you were onto something.
Did you? What I like bit the did idea, I lose it then?
I like the idea of Grant running in and out of rooms with Jordan. Yeah. Oh, get in the cupboard!
Yeah, that's it.
Your
doors
boobs
opening.
Are too big!
Yeah, that's it. Oh, squeezing that,
yeah,
you
that
in,
would be
you
hilarious.
Know. Yeah.
That I love. But it was the zombies that ruined it for me.
All right, then what happens to Hugh Grant if he's poisoned by the chocolate cake?
He dies.
And oh, it's a sobering
lesson about not cheating on Emma Thompson.
Oh,
see, I was thinking with Revenge of the Chocolate Cake, maybe chocolate cake was a code name for something. Like, it could either be a kind of international assassin known as
chocolate cake.
I don't know why. Or
just because,
like,
you got a small casting role in 24, you're now Robert
now
Ludlum.
I think I know what I'm doing. Or it's like a Godzilla type monster known as the chocolate cake, and then it has revenge on something. I prefer yours.
Sarah, thank you very much, you're cool. Right, we've run out of time. Stephen, thank you very much for coming in.
I appreciate it.
I look forward to your future projects, Revenge of the Chocolate Cake,
revenge of the
and
chocolate
of course the big one, Shrubbery. I still stand by Shrubbery. Okay, you listen, you're going to be going out to Hollywood soon, I'm sure, in the next couple of months for meetings. You have these pitch meetings.
Yeah.
Could you just spend 5 minutes out of your time pitching on my behalf Shrubbery? And just let me know
how far
it would go.
I wonder how far you could get.
I think with your standing at the moment, and just lie and say that you've already spoken to De Niro's people, they're really excited by it. Because what's it called? Aren't people get attached to projects?
They get attached to projects. We've got Charles attached. Yeah. If we can't get the Royal Command performance as well of this film, I'll be very disappointed.
Brilliant. Good luck with Cemetery Junction. It's out now. Stephen, it's always a lot of fun seeing you. Thank you very much for coming, and look forward to seeing Shrubbery.
Thank you.